Hi, welcome. I'm Drippy and I will be guiding you through the steps. Let's get started. Start with the bathroom faucet that you think gets used the most. You will start by getting a baseline measurement. This is the current flow of your faucet before removing the aerator. Put a bowl under the faucet to catch excess water. Turn on the faucet full blast. Person A will use the stopwatch and will tell person B when to put the flow rate back under the faucet and when to remove it. Collect the water for 5 seconds. Hold the bag by the top corners and at an eye level to determine what line the water reached. This shows gallons per minute. As you can see on my bag, I collected about 2.7 gallons per minute. That is a lot of water. Empty the water on a bucket or a large container for later use. Write your findings on the baseline flow rate table found in your booklet under step 1. Repeat the procedure 2 more times. Write your results and calculate the average. This will give you the average flow rate. Now let's remove the aerator. Most aerators can be removed by hand. You can use a small cloth for better grip if needed. If unable to remove it by hand, use pliers, but make sure to use the cloth around the aerator. After removing the aerator, you will measure the water flow without the aerator, just like we did with the baseline flow. We only need to do this once. Write your findings on the flow rate without aerator box on your booklet. Let's install the new aerator, but before we do that, let's check that there's nothing left on the faucet from the old aerator. Install the new aerator using your hand, and again, you can use a cloth for better grip. Tighten it as much as you can, and then turn the faucet to check for leaks. If there's a leak, you can use pliers to tighten it a little more, but make sure to use a cloth around the aerator to prevent the pliers from scratching it. And do not tighten it too much. Now that we have a new aerator, we're going to measure the water flow rate with the new aerator by following the same steps as before, and write your findings on the flow rate with new aerator table. You will take 3 measurements and then calculate the average. This will give you the average flow rate with new aerator.